Spin orbitrates another precious resource, which is another core service, namely the CPU. Spin only decides at a macro level the amount of time that is given to a particular extension. That's done through the Spin global scheduler. The global scheduler interacts with the application threads package. An application is a loose term here. It is the extension that is living on top of Spin, which may be an entire operating system or maybe just an application. For example, let's say we are running Linux and Vista as two extensions on top of Spin. Each may be given a particular time slice, say of X milliseconds. How each extension uses the time that has been given to it for scheduling user-level processes running inside those operating system is entirely up to those extensions. And to support the concept of threads in the operating system and management of time, Spin provides an abstraction called Strand. The actual operating systems that extend Spin will have their threads mapped to strands. So Strand is the unit of scheduling that Spin's global scheduler uses. But the semantics of the strand is entirely decided by the extension. If, for instance, I'm implementing pthreads, I will define the semantics of the strand to be the semantics of the pthread scheduler. And there are event handlers that help in the scheduling that needs to happen in the extensions. And the kind of events that Spin provides for this core service of CPU scheduling are block, unblock, checkpoint, and resume. And the extensions event handlers have to give the semantic meaning of what needs to happen when these event handlers are called, because these are only interface functions. What needs to happen when this interface function is called is up to the extension. For example, a disk interrupt handler may result in an unblock event being raised for a particular strand that was waiting for the disk I/O completion. Similarly, if an application were to make a system call that is a blocking system call, then the service that provides that facility to the application will raise this block event, which will result in the extension taking the appropriate action of saving the state of the currently running process and putting it in the appropriate queues that it has to wait for that system call completion. So in a nutshell, what Spin provides are exactly the kind of primitives that may be needed by an extension that wants to provide the service of CPU scheduling. So Spin only provides the interface function definitions. The semantics are all up to the extension on how exactly the scheduling is effected. And all that Spin does is to ensure that the extension gets time on the CPU through this global scheduler that Spin has for allocating time to different extensions that may be concurrently living on top of Spin.